so it needs to be elastic.
Yes, we are going to look at types of elasticity of demand. Types of what? Elasticity of demand. We say that the kind of elasticity, the type of elasticity of demand that fuel or petrol has is not the same that bomb meter has, isn't it? Two of them have different kinds of elasticity of demand. Why? Because if there is a change, little change in price of fuel or petrol, you keep buying it, isn't it? But products like Milo or Bonvita that have substitute, when they are changing their price, you see people stopping to buy them or reducing their quantity demanded and going for the substitute, isn't it? So those classes of demands or elasticity of demand is what we are going to learn today in types of what? Elasticity. Types of elasticity. Number one is elastic demand. We have elastic demand, we have inelastic demand, we have unity elastic demand and other types, you understand? But first of all, we take the first one, elastic demand. What is elastic demand? Demand is said to be elastic if a small change in price leads to a greater change in quantity of goods demanded. Is that clear? Whenever there is a little change in price, and you see that the quantity of goods demanded changes, you understand, tremendously. When you have such, we call it what? Elastic demand. So who can tell me an example of goods that have elastic demand? What? Rice. How? From the examples that I have given already, you can pick out the one that has elastic demand. Which one has elastic demand and why? Elastic demand is whenever there is a small change in price, there is what? Large change in quantity demanded. Once you change price, you see people will not buy again. Milo, any commodity that has a substitute, you understand? Whenever there is a small change in its price, you will see a very large change in the what? Quantity demanded. If people were demanding 1,000 before, all of a sudden they can be demanding only what? One. Because there is substitute, they will leave it and go to the what? Substitute. So you see that all those what's it called? Competitive demand goods that we give, like Milo and Bonvita, most of them have what to call what? Elastic demand. Once there is a little change in their price, you understand? People start buying them. And once people now, once there is a little decrease in their price, what will happen? Plenty of people will want to buy more. So that is elastic demand. So we now say that in this elasticity, it is the coefficient of elasticity, E, is always what? Greater than what? One. Greater than or equal to one, but less than what? Infinity. This is the graph. When there is change in price, can you see the change in price? Price moves from BA to what? BB. Just more, because of this small change, there is what? Large change in our what? Large change in demand. There is large change. Can you see that the space between here and here is bigger than the space between here and here, isn't it? So this is what we call a fairly elastic demand. You can call it elastic demand or what? Fairly elastic demand. Is that clear? Is that clear? Good. So we're going to look at the second type of elasticity of demand. We're going to look at what? The second type, known as inelastic demand. Number two.
I will have two of these, which is what? Two, eight, and
inelastic demand.
Eight.
And demand is set to be
fluoride atom
inelastic if a larger change in price leads to small or slight change in the quantity of goods demanded. Exactly. So when you have such, you have inelastic. Here, the elasticity or the coefficient of elasticity. Whenever I say elasticity, know that it also means what? Coefficient of elasticity is less than zero. That is, elasticity E
equals to greater than zero.
Less than zero, but what?
Less than one.
Is greater than zero, but less than one. So it's negative. This type of elasticity can also what? Be called fairly inelastic. Fairly inelastic demand. Is that clear? So it can also be plotted in the graph like the other one. That will have BA. That will have what? BA and what? BB. And we'll have Q. QA and QB. Understand? Whereby here we have the what? Price. And here we have the what? Quantity demanded. So when the price moves from BA, given a quantity of QA, to BB, given a quantity of what? QB.
And the other ratio, how many electrons? One and what? Two. Let's put them together to give us quantities. That's two electrons.
So we have these 2 points.
So remember the rule that says that it was the complete same length as the
other. It's not bright to pay attention.
Then we have chlorine.
So inelastic demand is when a large change in price.
Alright.
You understand? Causes a very what? Little or no change in quantity demanded. You can give me an example of a good that does that. The price changed very well, but people still they buy them. You know to change.
Petrol.
You understand? All those products that they are used, that you must buy them. Even if there is large change in price. You see that they change the price of fuel from 87 naira to 140. Still people are doing what? Because you cannot do without them, isn't it? So those goods that you cannot do without, most of them are have what kind of demand? Inelastic demand. Because what? If there is a what? Large change in their price, it leads to only small or slight change in the quantity what? Demanded. People still demand for it almost the same price, almost the same quantity, you understand? The quantity never changes a month. You understand? If they continue to increase the price of petrol, and the quantity of petrol you need to get from here to town is 20 liters. You still be buying 20 liters, isn't it? Even when the price is increasing. So if petrol has what? Inelastic what? Demand. Is that clear? So that's what we show in this graph. Can you see the change in price? It will move from all the way from here to here. Understand? But the change in quantity is very small. So the graph is always steep. This graph is always what? Steep. Whereas the graph for the other one is what? It's like this, even. You understand? That's another way Jam asks you the question. The elasticity of demand that has a steep curve. Is it elastic or inelastic? The one that has a steep curve is what? Inelastic. The one that has an even curve is what? Elastic. Elastic has even curve. Inelastic has what? Steep. Steep curve or steep graph. Is that clear? Is that clear?
So the outermost shell
will keep coming.
Becomes what? What's not the outermost shell? For the pure energy. The outermost shell is still the M shell, right? So this is 2 and 8. We have what? It's not complete. It's not completed octets. It's not complete 8. So it's from what? 1, 2,
So we're going to look at another type of elasticity, the third one, known as unity or unitary elastic demand. Unitary or unity elastic demand. The man is said to be what?
Calcium plus what? He's said to be unitary when it changes
to calcium. To be unitary when a change in price leads to an equal change in the quantity of the goods or commodity demanded. Is that clear? So here there is what? Equal is equal. Here the coefficient of elasticity is what? Here the coefficient of elasticity is equal to 1. That is, E is equal to what? 1. Is that clear? It could be shown in this graph where we have price and what? Quantity what? Demanded. So when you have BA and what? BB, isn't it? You can also have what? QA and what? QB, isn't it? This one led to what? This one, and this one led to this one. You have a curve like that. Here E is equal to 1. Leave what you're writing and pay attention. So in unity or unitary elastic demand, demand is said to be unitary when a change in price leads to what? Equal. Leads to what? Equal change in quantity of good. It's equal now. You understand? If the price changes by 5 naira, the quantity demanded will reduce by 5. Is that clear? So when you have such goods, you say that that's, such goods has what we call unitary what? Elasticity. Is that clear? Here the elasticity is equal to what? 1. Equal to what? 1. You see the curve. The curve of elastic demand is like this. Isn't it? The curve of inelastic is like this. Steep. Isn't it? Whereas the curve of this one is at the middle. Can you see it? Can you see the difference? Damp is going to draw the curves and ask you what kind of demand elasticity. Send it in here. If this is your curve, if you have something like this, what kind of elasticity? Unity. If you have something like this, what kind of elasticity?
Elastic.
Elastic. Then if you have something like this, what kind of elastic? Siva. Elastic. Unitary. In what? Elastic. You understand? This one is greater than 1. But this one is less than
0.
Less than 0, but whereas this one is what? 1. This one is 1 itself. But this one is greater than 1. Right, this one is negative. Exactly. So take it down. Are you done? Let's move to another one.
Calcium plus what? 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 Calc
we are going to look at another type of elasticity. Two of them are still remaining. Two are still remaining. Two are still remaining. Two are still remaining. And the two, number four, is what we call perfectly elastic demand, or another word for it is what? Infinitely elastic what? Demand. And demand is said to have demand
to be perfectly elastic.
Is said to be perfectly elastic.
When a change in price brings.
If a change in what?
Price brings about an increase.
In price brings about. Brings about what? An infinite, infinite effect on the quantity of what goods demanded. Is that clear? So, if you have a graph like this, where you have the price, PA. Because of increasing from this point to PA, the quantity demanded continues to what? Change a lot. We call it what? We call it a perfectly elastic what? Demand. Also, very similar to that is what we call perfectly in perfectly inelastic what? Demand.
Or zero elastic demand.
Or another name for it is zero elastic what? Demand. And a demand is said to be a zero or perfectly what?
It's said to be perfectly inelastic.
Or zero elastic what? Demand.
If a change in price has no effect.
If a change
in price.
In price.
Has no effect whatsoever.
Has no what?
Effect. Whatsoever.
Whatsoever.
On the quantity of goods.
On the
quantity
of goods what demanded. Here the coefficient of elasticity is what? Equal to zero. Whereas here the coefficient of elasticity is equal to what? It's equal to infinity. You understand? Here it's equal to infinity. Here it's equal to zero. So stop writing. Let me explain. I'll give you time to write. Can you see these two? In this one, it is said to be perfectly inelastic. If a change in price brings about an infinite change in what? Quantity of goods demanded. There are some substitute goods or competitive demand products that have such. Once there is a small, just small change in price, everybody will leave it as, hey, we don't want them again, or go use this one. Nobody will even want to buy at all. There is a change in the quantity demanded because of just a little change in price. You can give me an example of such product. Or another person should also give me an example of a product that has perfectly elastic, which is when there is a change in price, it doesn't have any effect on the quantity. This one is very simple to give an example. Give me an example of this one. No, no, no. Water. Even if you increase the price of water to 1 million, will you not still use water? Will you not use water? Does water have any substitute whatsoever? Is there anything that you can use in place of water? So even if the price of water keep changing, they sell pure water from 5 naira, 10 naira, 20 naira, any amount, will that reduce the amount of water you take? So the change in price of water does not affect whatsoever the number of demand. You understand? You will always use water to do what? Bath. You will use it to do what? Cook. You understand? So those things that are very, very important, they tend to have perfectly inelastic what? Demand. Is that clear? So what are those things that once you change their price, nobody will even near there again? Or once you reduce their price, people will leave the other one and go to it. This one could also be seen in it's likely. Cement is likely. If you leave tomato, what will you go to?